Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I'll be showing you how I created this flyer in CorelDraw, of course with few steps. If you don't mind, come, let's get started. So first things first, click on file, and when you click on file, I'm just going to make this settings here. Make sure your primary color mode is set to RGB 5x5. You're using inches, and you just input the name of this particular design here, just like this. Right, great. When you're done, click OK. It brings you inside here. Double click on this rectangle, like we've done in previous video, to make a replica of the workspace, and that we can add color to it. That's just the essence. Now click on this color here, like this. You can see it's too light, but we'll fix this. Okay, so I'm just going to hold down Control or Command and click on this black to make the blue a little bit darker. I think I like this, like the way it is. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going over to my resource file. Of course, my resource file is in the description of this video, so do well to download them so we can all be on the same page. Okay, good. So with this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce the size like this, and make it a little bit smaller. Go over to transparency, and I'm just going to drag from white to black so I conceal that region there. Press go to your transparency again, and I'm going to stretch this up a bit, right? So I'm just going to adjust it. So I'm taking this out because I want to power clip it inside, so take it out. Click on power clip, and when this arrow comes, just click on the rectangle. That's all, very simple. Double click on it to have access to it. Then you can now choose to increase the size like this. Make sure you are resizing from the edge, guys. When you're resizing, make sure you click on shift, just like this. Okay, so you can then position this in place to have it just the way you want it. Okay, so if you feel it's not in place like the way you want it, you can go back into the power clip. So I'm just going to convert this to bitmap, convert to bitmap, and go to effects under adjust image adjustment lab. Make sure your preview is turned on, click on reset, and I'm just going to, you can copy my settings for this, right? So the goal of this is to make the image itself punchy and very vibrant, right? So when I'm done, I'm just going to click OK and click finish to click out, right? So now that that is out of the way, I'm going over to bring next image, which is this first one here. So we that we're in the ministry of drag and drop, just drag it inside and drop. But if you cannot use the drag and drop, please always make sure you use the import command, right? So using my shape tool, I'm just going to take this in. The shape tool selected, I'm going to take this in too. And for the top parts, take this in also. This step is very important when you're designing CorelDraw, so you don't have things outside, and when you save, you have this empty white annoying space outside. Again, reset this, reduce saturation. I'm going to drag this all up, and let's see, I think I need shadows. I'm going to take this in to apply more shadows to it this way, and highlights, do I need them? Okay, just a bit. You can copy my settings just to be on a safe part, right, and use them. So I'm just going to bring this in like this, and I'm going to click on mirror. No, not that, this one. Great. So then of course I will need to get rid of these edges, so I'll go to transparency, and I'll just click and drag to do this. Okay, so I'm going to position this here, move it in like this, okay, and I'm just going to bring in the next one, which is this image. Drag and drop inside like this. Of course, I'm going to do what I did to that other image. Go to your shape tool, and so you can get rid of all of these things. Do the same thing to this part. Highlight, do the same thing here. Great. So I'm just going to shift this up a bit like this. Effect, adjust, then image adjustment lab. Since I have used this setting on the last image, so I'm going to maintain this, but I'm just going to tweak it a bit, or probably just leave it like this, right? So I'm just going to make it smaller, and still reduce the size. Hold down shift while you are reducing from the edge like this to make it perfect. Of course, I'll still need to make this smaller from the way I see it. So make it smaller like this. Then I'll use my transparency to blur this out. Shift this up a bit. Also move this up a bit. Okay, so there you go. Going over to bring in the last image for this process, which is this image. So I'm just going to go over and do what I've done with the previous images. All right. Okay, so I'm just going to reduce the size like this up until this point like this, and reduce like this, and I'm going to bring it here. Okay, great. So I'm going to do what I did with the remaining ones. I'm going to go to adjustment, image adjustment lab. Of course, I've done this to previous images. I just have to tweak this a bit. I think with this I really have to tweak this so it doesn't look too dark and all of that. So when I'm done, I'm going to click OK. Right, and I'm going to reduce the size of this one particular, and I think I want to push this up a bit. Good. So I would also get rid of the hard corners using my transparency tool, just like this. When I'm done, I'll highlight everything and make it smaller and move it up just like this, right, so that I have room for every other thing to come in. So for this background, I would like to make it slightly bigger, so I'll just go and then increase the size. Okay, okay, so I'll just go over to my text tool, click on the A and the toolbox, that's your text tool, and I'm just going to type a few things. So I'm just going to speed this up now like this. Okay, so I'm just going to select the feast and prayers, and I'm going to objects, and I'm going to convert them to curve like this, and I'm going to weld them together so I can apply the same color to both of them and it stays the same, right? So selecting this, I'm going to click on select my gradient. The shortcut for that is G. Just press G on your keyboard and drag from this point to this point. So I'm just going to use these two colors like this. I'm just going over to add some extra text to this. So right about now, I'm gonna speed things up. Okay, so basically we have all our text in place, so we're just going to do a bit of minor formatting. Okay, so this is good. I'm just going to leave space here. Right, and extend it a bit. So going over to my rectangle, I'm going to draw a rectangle here like this. But this rectangle is going to be different. So the first thing I want to do is, let's see, okay, I'll leave it like this. I make a duplicate copy of this. Control C, Control V, then bring this down. But before I do that, I'm converting it to curve, Control Q. Then I'm going to bring this part inside. Make a duplicate copy of this. And selecting the two of them, I'm going to move it up. So I'm just going to right drag to copy the effect, right? Or better still, let's do this manually. Select this color, right? Then just drag from this part here to this part and change the color like this. Do the same thing, give it this color. Click on G, drag, select the white, and apply this color like this. So select the two of them, also remove the background too. Right, so I'll just go ahead and with my text too, and I'm just going to type the information I need there. Okay, so with that done, I'm just going to go over to the pen tool. I'm going to click, hold down shift and double click to draw a straight line. Use shape tool if you have an extra to get rid of it. And I'm going to change the color to white like this. Right, So select it and move it up just like this. Go over to your rectangle and draw from the edges like this up onto this point. Select this color, remove the outline and go to transparency, uniform transparency, and so cut this, double click on the rectangle and paste it inside. Right, when you are done, click on finish. Right, great. So I did this just to make sure that the information here is noticeable. Do you understand? So I'm going to copy all of that and paste it inside the power clip. Select everything like this and I'm going to move it upwards like this so that I have room for more information to stay at the base. Okay, great. So my rectangle tool selected, I'm just going to draw a rectangle here and I'm going to give it white like this. So simply I'm just going to go over to add the last details for this flyer. Okay, so lastly I'm going to go over to my resource file and I'm going to bring in the last element for this design. So with this one I'm going to make it smaller and put it here. This is the church logo. My text tool, I'm just going to write a few things. Okay guys, so I'll just move this up and this is how I created this nice looking church flyer in CorelDraw. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you've not subscribed. Now is the best time to, and make sure you turn on the post notification so you miss any video I'll be dropping anytime from now. I'll see you in the next video.